House Democrats are moving toward a Sunday showdown on health care. The president is again delaying a trip abroad to stick around for the vote. And today he makes another public pitch for the bill. Political analyst Mark Sandalo is joining us live in Washington to talk about the upcoming vote. Great to see you again, Mark. First of all, where does the vote stand today? And give us an update on Congressman Joseph Gow and Charlie Malasa, if you will.
Yeah, Melanie, this vote is very, very close. Democrats are increasingly confident. They need 216 votes to pass this. That means they can afford to lose 37 votes, and Democrats will have this passed. They can afford to lose 37. In November, when they passed another health care bill, 39 Democrats defected. So they need to pick up a couple. They're pretty confident they have it, but I'll tell you, Representative Mel Cohn does not sound very enthusiastic about it, and the assumption in Washington is that he is likely to vote no. Representative Gow, the sort of unlikely Republican representative from New Orleans, is the only chance this bill has to be bipartisan, because there is not another Republican in the entire United States in Congress who is talking about voting for this thing. The president has actually spent some time talking to Gow on the phone. I believe he invited him to the White House. Not sure if that meeting actually physically took place, but what the president is trying to convince him is, if Representative Gow is concerned about the abortion language in here, that is, there's some concerns that public money could go towards abortion. What Obama is trying to convince Representative Gow is that there are protections to make sure that doesn't happen. And boy, it's Obama's only chance to make this a bipartisan bill.
But Mark, just to perhaps appease Congressman Gow, because I know he's sort of being talked to in Congress, if you will, is there any chance that at this point the Senate would change the language in the Senate's version of the bill because the abortion language is such a point of contention?
You know, if only they could, Melanie, they probably want to. But here's the problem, is the Senate doesn't want to touch this bill, or as little as possible, because since the election in Massachusetts, when Ted Kennedy was replaced by a Republican, if the Senate try to deal with it again, it could be subject to a filibuster. This is where this complex parliamentary maneuvering is going on. So the only touches the Senate is going to make to the bill are strictly on budgetary matters, because then through this process known as reconciliation, they can avoid a filibuster and do it with a simple majority. The abortion language is really not a budget matter, so they really can't tinker with it much. So that's why it's somewhat fixed right now. One interesting fact to keep in mind, though, is the more a nation provides health care, this is worldwide, the less abortions there are, either because women decide that they can carry their babies to term and have to be burdened financially, or because they get more contraception. But there are a lot of abortion foes, including in the Catholic Church, who say, you know what, we ought to expand health care, because if we want to reduce abortions, it's a good way to do it.
Yeah, well, as you know, New Orleans is largely Catholic, so it's been a big point of contention here as well, dividing the Catholic Church. Mark Sandalo, thank you so much for your time. It's always great to see you. And the president is speaking out more about his delayed trips overseas. In an interview today, Mr. Obama says it made sense to wait until June so his visit won't be rushed. As for his trip to Virginia this morning, he'll address a crowd of about 10,000 at George Mason University.